Kia ora, good evening. Light rail and still light on details. The government may be spinning today's announcement on light rail for Auckland as back on track, but it's being slammed as back to the drawing board. It is 4 years since Jacinda Ardern promised trams would be speeding through Auckland by now. Katie Bradford with today's developments.
6 years, repeated stop starts, one of the most contentious transport projects in recent history. And now, the new Transport Minister throwing the botched light rail plan back to square one.
Today, I'm drawing a line under it.
Starting again means setting up a group to spend 6 months consulting with Aucklanders.
Completing an indicative business case to enable decisions to be made on mode, route, and providing cost estimate and funding and financing options.
Labor's blaming New Zealand First for stopping the project in its tracks in the last term of government, but many were also unhappy at a lack of consultation.
Engagement needs to take place, but that should have been the case in 2017. We've simply wasted 4 years.
And we need to speed it up. The government predicts 17% of the city's population, job and housing growth will be along the corridor from the central city through Mount Roskill to the south. But we don't even know what route or mode the transport fix might take. The ambition is for it to connect the city centre to the airport via the Mangere corridor.
I would just like to see anything happen in Auckland. We're completely inert and the government's to blame.
Actually, we don't have a business case right now, so we need to see a business case to see if light rail even stacks up, because quite frankly, nobody knows.
Others are keen that businesses don't suffer in the process.
What we'd like to see is whatever corridor they land on, it's a better job than what happened with Albert Street and the huge impact on businesses there. I think there's a lot to be learned from that.
$1.6 billion in seed funding has been set aside, but it'll cost a lot more than that, and we don't even know who will pay for it. So, when are we actually going to see people jumping on board?
Look, that work has to be done. That's not a question that I can answer today, but we're setting up the process to make sure that we make the right decisions. We'll have a delivery entity moving into the next phase of this project.
Right now, it's certainly not rapid rail, more like snail's pace.
Disappointing news for many Aucklanders today, Katie. How much has this process cost so far?
Well, the government's told me it's spent $5 million so far, $5 million to simply get nowhere. Labor has failed to deliver on that 2017 election promise. And while New Zealand First is partly to blame, they did put the kibosh on this project just before the last election. Labor also failed to consult properly. Michael Wood, the new Transport Minister, didn't want to comment much on that today, but he is promising that under his watch, this project will go ahead. But of course, we simply don't have any details about when we will see that. And that's disappointing for Aucklanders. It's disappointing for people stuck in traffic. It's disappointing for people who want a fast, easy way to get to the airport. And it's things we never learn from our history. We never learn about making these decisions, doing this right when it comes to these big infrastructure projects that we desperately need to get this country moving.
Kia ora, Katie. Thanks very much for that.